From Creamer Media in Johannesburg, this is the Real Economy Report. South Africa's largest coal producer and black-empowered coal company, Exxaro, has unveiled its new ultramodern headquarters in Gauteng. Tasneem Bulbulia tells us more.
Exxaro occupied the new 18,000 square meter building in West Street opposite the Centurion Gauteng station in June. Exxaro Resources Group Manager for Safety and Health, Dr. Joseph Machila, outlines the new premises.
The new Exxaro facility, which is called the Connection, was actually inspired by the Exxaro corporate strategy, the 2026 strategy, which is based on Exxaro's vision of powering possibilities in Africa and beyond. So at the heart of the Connection is the building being an enabler to achieve the outcomes of the strategy. Part of it was a workplace ambition of Exxaro of having a connected workforce. So what you will see in the building is workspaces that are activity based, but driving predominantly getting people connected. So the spaces created in a building are actually anchored on that. Another important pillar that you're going to see in the building is digital at Exxaro, of having a modern facility that talks to Exxaro's ambition of a digital solution being an enabler for the business. Being in the extractive industry, Exxaro has always been sensitive about the impacts it has on the environment. So you see part of the attributes of the building, starting with the way the building was designed, as well as the way the building is operated, is driven by our water conservation ambition. You've been shown facilities of the building where water conservation measures have been put in place. Energy efficiency, you look at the lighting of the building, is inspired by, you know, energy efficiency aspiration, the lifts on the building. And we also embrace the type of vehicles that you're going to see in the future, which are electric vehicles. So if, for example, you go to the parking lot, you see we have made provisions for electric vehicles. We also have a very innovative waste management solution. Look, part of the Exxaro's modernization aspiration is also to have less paper. So when we do have paper, we are informed by the recycling ambitions of reducing waste, recycling waste. So even the way we contracted with the service providers for the building, we looked at how they will be managing waste papers from the building.
Machila explains how this considerable investment in the new premises showcases the company's commitment to and confidence in the country.
We are a South African company. Our aspirations are fully rooted in South Africa. And if you look at Exxaro's investment in the recent past, it talks to that. We are making significant investments, not only here in Pretoria or Tshwane in terms of facilities, but even if you look at our operations, Belfast mine in Emakazeni is a testimony to that significant investment, which is the confidence that Exxaro has in South African economy.
Machila details some of the benefits that the building engenders.
It's sitting on a very strategic node of Gauteng. There was a deliberate exercise of picking up a office space that is located to traffic infrastructure. It's easily accessible from the main highway of South Africa, which is the N1, but we are smack bang opposite Gauteng. So if you do not want to use your own private vehicle, you can easily access the connection through the Gauteng.
Built by Growth Point, the building has a 5-star Green Star SA rating from the Green Building Council of South Africa. Growth Point Development Manager Michael Gerber touches on the project process.
The timeline, the process started about 5 years ago, where Exxaro approached Growth Point due to our expertise in development and we collaborated with Exxaro.
The building is regarded as a physical manifestation of Exxaro's drive to make use of innovative technology to improve operations and protect the environment. Gerber expands on some of the innovative touch points that Growth Point has implemented in the building.
We've got a urine harvesting plant where we capture all the urine And we've entered into an SLA agreement with a service provider which can collect the urine, extract the nutrients, which is phosphate, nitrogen, and that allows them to create fertilizer out of that process, as well as knowledge sharing. And we did two steps where we've developed a dashboard, which is placed in public spaces where we communicate and educate staff and visitors with regards to the water and energy consumption performances of the building, and also put in a little bit of a competition where the different levels compete with each other and see who's the most economic with their water and electrical use. We also put on display the geotechnical conditions of the site and again knowledge sharing through what challenges there were, how we overcame those challenges, and communicating that to whoever wants to have a view on the physical dolomite pinnacles that we encountered, the dolomite class hazard 8 that we've experienced on site, which is your highest hazardous rates on dolomite, and yeah, how we overcame that and just sharing that knowledge.
A major challenge in the building's construction was the site's dolomitic bedrock. Gerber expands on this and explains how it was mitigated.
So with any development, you've got your challenges. This was our major challenge, which is a known challenge for the Centurion node. And through expertise and new engineering technologies, what was not possible a couple of years ago, where Council of Geoscience and Council of Geoscience did not even allow us to breach or build across a Class 8 material, we were able now to span and construct a 2.25 meter thick raft that caters for a 50 meter loss of support in the event of a sinkhole forming. The building is founded on a 2.25 meter thick raft, and obviously early warnings in future should there be an early sign of sinkhole forming, we've placed strategically probes, we call them extensometers, within the weak dolomite. It's probes, and as the probe moves, it will send through an early warning signal to the BMS system, which will forewarn of a potential sinkhole that might form. But again, this raft is designed to ensure that there's no life loss. It's purely at that point there might be some deflection in the raft and you might have some cosmetic damage to finishes. But that's really in the event of a worst case sinkhole forming of up to 15 meters, which is very rare. So the engineering solution to enable us to build this type of building on top of this type of geotechnical condition, yeah, it's an innovation in itself, which we're proud of.
That's Creamer Media's Real Economy Report. Join us again next week for more news and insights into South Africa's real economy. And don't forget to listen to the audio version of our Engineering News daily email newsletter.